visited here since the new bridge was built. It is not on the maps I used to use. Made at a predetermined time and place, the states of the weather and the tide are givens. Freezing rain and strong winds. I have a hood and a coat. Water splatters the viewfinder. It is hard to see what I am filming. Let the world in through imprecision. Try to hold the camera as steady as possible. Try to pan and zoom smoothly. It is so easy to be drawn into cliché. My aim was to keep walking, letting the eye and the camera collect whatever turned up. But part of walking is to stop, take bearings, take stock, consider more closely some object or some view. Try to feel what a thought brings, and to think about what a feeling is. emptiness can be a complete fullness. Down onto the intertidal zone, where the water might have been, and where it will be again soon. I have been here before. Farm, which used to be on the far shore, further down the coast. My father always had a small yellow arrows tied timetable for the estuary, as we grazed animals on the tidal salt marshes near the Cardiff docks. My hands are getting so cold that it is getting harder to use the camera controls. Other life is here. I grew up on a farm on the levels between Cardiff and Newport, somewhere on that far shore, a bit further down the coast. The farm is long gone. We all moved over the Severn Bridge to a new farm near Bath. From a hill on that farm, over the head of Bristol, the old Severn Bridge and the new Severn Bridge can be seen as distant white punctums in the landscape. My first school was on the banks of the Severn, on the great Oxbow Bend just below Gloucester. We could hear the tidal bore rushing up the river in the night. Then I went to school in Taunton, travelling over the Severn Bridge each time, driven by my parents. Then I lived in Bristol as a student, in one of the old Georgian terraces overlooking the Avon, nearly beneath the Clifton Suspension Bridge. Again the tides and the ships flowed past. I visited Yestry and its shoreline often, taking photographs, walking. I have collected local histories, local topographies. I have collected other people's photographs, looking out from one side to the other. I intended to edit old photographs into this film. I have strips of black and white negatives taken from Severn Beach which have never been developed. They are like unaccessed memories. And now here I am again, gazing out into the estuary. The wind barriers on the bridge block the view from a car. I look every time we cross. The Severn railway tunnel crosses under the river somewhere about here, unseen. I have been through it many times. Perhaps there is a train thundering through there now. A self in landscape, of landscape, memory and memories are replete with beyond sense and beyond coherence. How can we deal with these? Zooming as I walk fools the parallax for a moment. Imagine if we could record somehow, effect of becoming in action, the half-second delay, thoughts and emotions forming, and then slow it down. rum. 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 How can I forget the foghorn? We used to hear it on the farm, a foghorn down up by the channel. You could tell what the weather was like before you opened your eyes in the morning when the foghorn was going. Perhaps from here you'd have just have heard it. There is a parallax in memory. The walk animates the landscape around me, but also animates the past around me. As I turn, the wind drags across the mic again. I thank the rain for the sound. As I turn once more, I realize the wind is blowing east to west, down the estuary, and not in its normal westerly direction. The undesigned sudden pan and nod of the camera feels like looking away from something. as it is today, looking out into the estuary space, catches the noise of the wind. Times and heights of high and low tide vary each month and across the year, and slowly creep across the other framework of day and night.